Dozens and dozens of cars broken into, 70 in total, and all of them in just one night.
Atlanta police say that the car the thieves were driving was stolen and stocked full of stolen loot. Fox 5's Denise Dillon is live in Virginia Highland tonight. Denise, you talked to a lot of frustrated people out there tonight.
You bet. Police say using hammers and flashlights, this group of thieves just went from car to car, smashing the windows, sometimes getting away with valuable items, other times getting away with nothing, just breaking the windows.
Pretty frustrating. Very annoyed.
Smashed car windows, shattered glass has folks frustrated and angry.
I don't understand it. People have nothing else to do. You might as well go get a job.
Thieves broke into Thomas Marshall's car and got away with his and his wife's wedding bands. They had left them in the car when they went to the gym.
Go with it, like about a half a carat going around the front of it.
They weren't alone. Atlanta police say at least 70 cars were broken into overnight. The thieves covered a lot of ground.
In neighborhoods as far north as Buckhead, coming down through the downtown footprint and into the eastern Atlanta footprint, there's a considerable amount of area.
In a very short time.
That it only takes about 5 seconds to break into each vehicle.
20 of those break-ins happened in this parking lot off Ponce.
That is insane.
One man says he heard the commotion about 2:30 in the morning and looked out his window and saw two teenagers inside this Pilot. He says he saw two more, one on a skateboard, another on a motorized scooter, going through the parking lot. He says when cops pulled in, all four of them took off running. Police say they recovered the car the thieves were in. They say it turned out to be stolen 2 days earlier out of DeKalb County. And they arrested this man, DeClarence McGee, and believe he's related to the crimes. Police say when they found him on this street, he wasn't wearing pants, and no one seems to know where they were.
I haven't the slightest idea, but unfortunately, we know where they weren't.
As for the car owners who are left with a mess, they realize it could have been much worse.
At least it was our cars. It wasn't anything personal. You definitely don't feel personal when it's, or take it personally when it's 70 cars in the area, but still kind of hits you hard.
Now, police say in that stolen car that they recovered, they found valuable items, cell phones, and numerous book bags. But in some cases, the crooks didn't get anything out of the cars because the owners didn't leave anything valuable in sight. Coming up at 11, I'll tell you what police have to say about leaving a clean car, but still getting your window smashed in. Reporting live in Virginia Highland, Denise Dillon, Fox 5 News.
Certainly more to the story. All right, Denise, we'll see you tonight on News Edge at 11.